Welcome back to Let Us Learn to Lead video series on free open source software designed by M. Srinivasan, Training Associate Mathematics, Kendra Vidyalaya Sangathan, Zonal Institute of Education and Training, Mumbai. Self-learning contents in video form on GeoGebra, a dynamic mathematics software, is presented at this video series. To view the contents, you may join Google Classroom by using the class code 73AUMBO. In this video, you will learn designing a worksheet to visualize the types of hyperbolas. For preparing this video lecture, I used Windows 10 operating system, a licensed version, GeoGebra 5.0, a free open source software, and free open source screen recorder software. Let us start. Let me show you what type of worksheet we will be designing. We will be designing a worksheet for hyperbola type 1. And we will tell them that the foci will be on x-axis, the transverse axis is along the x-axis. We will tell what is its foci and what is its vertices, okay? Then length of the transverse axis, length of the conjugate axis, we will show them with all colors. Now we can move this A, or you can move this B, and you can show them different types of hyperbolas. Here you are seeing that you are getting the third form also, so that a child can visualize it. Similarly, you can show them the type 2 also, which is having the foci on y-axis and transverse axis along the y-axis. Here also, we have shown it separately. We can move this A, or you can move this B, and you can show them. And you can reduce it also, and you can show it accordingly, you can show them. Whatever child can come and visualize, the equation will come and the graph of that particular hyperbola also will be coming. Therefore, the child will enjoy it. Okay. Let us try to design this dynamic worksheet from scratch. For that, I have taken GeoGebra Classic 5 worksheet, where this graphic view is there, then algebra view is also there. I will go for hyperbola type 1. Okay, we will just call it as type 1. We want the hyperbola with the foci on x-axis, transverse axis, along x-axis. Okay. For drawing it, we can write its equation also if you want. Therefore, the general equation. Actually, we are taking only the equation whose center is the origin. Therefore, you can go for this a by b. Here you can type x square. From the symbol, you can go and type the square. X square by a square minus, again latex formula, y square. You can expand it so that you can see all of them, divided by b square is equal to 1. Okay, anyway, we are ready with that definition and all. Now we will go for a slider number 1 with 1 to 10. We will have only 1 to 10 because we are going to have it at square of it with increment 1. Okay. We will have one more slider once again from 1 to 10 with increment as 1. Anyway, we will keep this as 5 and okay, this at 4 and this at 3. Okay, just for known to have it as 1 and 1. Now, let us try to get the equation x square in the input box, x square. Okay, before we go for that, instead of just having the square and all, you can have a square. Let us try to have a into a or a square, whatever you want, you can type. Okay, now it is 16. B square. Okay, it is 9. Now let us try to type the equation of the hyperbola type number 1, x square by what is a square c, okay, minus y square. You have to remember that what is the square we are the square of that we are having by d, d is equal to 1. So you see, you got it. Now you can adjust it, you can change the color of it, everything you can do. Now you can tell the children that what is the value of a now. Therefore a is equal to, from the object you can go and type a, okay. Similarly b is equal to, from the object you can tell them what is b. For a is equal to, b is equal to 4. Now let us just go for explaining one after the other. We can go for the vertex. What will be the vertex? You know it is a comma 0. Therefore here you can have a comma 0, that is a, then the other one is minus a comma 0, okay, a and b. Therefore you can type it over here. Therefore the vertex is plus or minus a comma 0. For from the symbol, go for this plus or minus a comma 0 colon. What are the objects now? A and B. Okay. You see, when I move this, it's also changing. See, it is also changing. Okay, I will keep it at 4. Now, we know that we want the value of C. Okay, what is C? C is equal to A square plus B square. Therefore, it is A plus B. In this particular one, it is should be A square plus B square, for it is C plus D. Okay, for it is 25. Okay, now we want the square root of 25, SQRT of this 25, of this E, whatever may be E. Okay, that is F. Okay, now let us go for expanding that. C is equal to, go to the latex formula. We have to go for this square root, a square plus b square, therefore a square, sorry, a square, okay, I will do it once again, because that bracket is very very important for that square root, because it is a latex formula, it's a square root, that bracket you should not touch it, you should not get disturbed, that's all, a square. Plus b square, b square, okay, is equal to, for this particular for problem it is square root of, what is a square, it is c, okay, plus it is d, okay. What is the value of it? The value is f, value is f, okay. I think you have put that value of c now. Sometimes in the value of the C, whatever the F value we have found, sometimes it may be inside a square root. You have to keep it as a surd. Therefore, there is one formula, surd text of F. Okay, you are also getting 5 over here. But in some problem, it may not be that perfect square. In that case, you have to make use of this. Therefore, C is equal to, where I have written that C is equal to 5. Okay, what will be the foci now? The foci will be this f, f, f. Therefore, f is 5. Therefore, it will be on the x-axis. Therefore, f, 0. Then minus f, 0. C and D. But now you can type it now over here. The foci. You can write here plus or minus c, comma 0. What is it? Full colon. The points are C and D. Okay, well. Now we want the eccentricity. Eccentricity is nothing but C by A. Therefore, F by A. But you should know that what is actually F by A. Okay, it is 5 by 4. For actually, you can type over here also. That is eccentricity. Is equal to E, is equal to, now you can go for this latex formula, in that C by A, therefore C by A, which is equal to, from the latex formula, here what is C? For us, its value is f. Its value is f divided by a. A is a only. For here, a is a only. Now, always it is greater than 1. Okay. Now, you got the eccentricity. Now, you can type here the length of the major axis. It is 2 into a. Therefore, what is 2a? What is 2b? That also we can calculate. It is already coming over here. But you can type over here. Therefore, the length of transverse axis is equal to 2a is equal to, I think from here it is h. Therefore, from the object you go for h. Why we are taking this? Whenever we are changing it, automatically it changes. Is it okay? Okay. Then the length of conjugate axis is equal to 2b is equal to, already we have calculated it, it is I. Or we go for this I. Okay. Now we want the lattice rectum. It is 2b square by a. Therefore, 2 multiplied by what is b square? B square is nothing but d here. Therefore, d upon what is a? A is a only. Therefore, 2b square by a. B square is d here. That you have to remember. Or what is the value you got? I think you got it as 9 by 2. Okay, no issue. Okay, now therefore let us go to length of lattice rectum. You see, the child can come and visualize everything. The length of the lattice rectum, length of, I want a space so that a child can read it neatly. Therefore, here you have to type the formula. It is 2b square. For 2 b square, 2b square upon a. Therefore, its value is j. Therefore, its value is j. Okay, I think we got most of them. Okay. Now, you see, here when you are moving it, you see this also moves, then all the values also changing. At one particular spot, you can keep it here. Suppose if you want to express its equation, I think we have not done it. Therefore, the hyperbola is that also we can display. The hyperbola, I think we have not done it. We will do it now. No problem. Is x square. Therefore, go to the lattice formula. In that, you go for x square by what is a square? You are showing it over here. The a square is c. Therefore, c. You have to go and go to the object C. Go to the object C. Okay. Minus y square. Once again, let us go to the lattice formula. Y square. Have some patience. Y square. Here, I think square should come over here. Okay. Upon D. D is equal to 9. Good. Okay. Therefore, I think its equation is there. Then A is equal to there. B is equal to there. Okay. I think we have not done it. Okay. It can be shown to the children. Okay. Now, you can change it. You see, everything changes. Everything changes. Then when you change the B also, everything changes. Now, a child can come and visualize the total type 1. He will can understand that, okay, where is the focus? Which is the transverse axis and what is its eccentricity, everything. Okay. Now what I will do is, I will save this as type 1. Is it okay? I will save it somewhere in documents or somewhere. I will save as type 1. Now how to convert it into type 2? Very simple. Go to this. Again save as. You just save it as type 2. Okay. Save. Now type 1 is already saved. Now here what will to be changed? Here you have to change it as. It is type 2. Therefore, in the text, you have to type, it is type 2. Okay. Let us see what are the changes we have to make. So that the child will learn it better. Again, foci on which axis it should be? It is on the y axis. Then go to this. Then here, the transverse axis is along y axis. Okay. Now, what will be its equation? Its equation is not this. Its equation is y square. Therefore, y square by a square minus x square by b square is equal to 1. Okay. Now let us try to change this equation. Now it is very simple. Go for this object properties. Here instead of this c, okay, here you put y square. Okay, here you put x square. Press enter. Oh, automatically it's changed. Is it okay? Now you see, it is automatically changed. Everything is automatically changed. Now the value of a and b are actually, you know, what is a and b, and by just changing it you will get it. For a is actually automatically 3, b is 3. Then what is the thing which you have to change? Here you have to change the vertex and everything you have to change. Therefore this you show the object, this you show the object, because these are all the vertices and the focus of the previous first type. For now we have to totally change it, that's all. It is very very simple. Therefore the I will just show only the vertex. The remaining thing I think all of you can change it automatically. It is 0 comma plus or minus a. You do the changes, whatever the changes you want to make, you make it. Okay, these are will go. Okay, these are will not be there. Okay, now what are the points now? Therefore the vertices are 0 comma plus or minus a. For what are the points now? It is on the vertices are on the y axis. Therefore it is 0 comma a. You see, you will get it immediately. Okay, you got it now. E. Therefore 0 comma minus a. Finish. E and f. Therefore go to this vertex, go to this object property. There you type here E and F. That's all, very simple. You got it. Okay. Similarly, you see here you are getting the value of C as 5 over here, but this to be changed. Okay. Therefore again go to the object property. Again C and D should not be there. Okay. This also should be changed. Accordingly you change 0 comma plus or minus C. Okay. Then let me try to find what is it actually. Now it is 5. Therefore C. Therefore C is nothing but I think we have know that it is F. Therefore it should be 0 comma F. That is the first point. Got it. Then 0 comma minus F. The second point. Okay, G and I think this is should be I think this point H. Therefore here you go and then go to the object property. There here you type in the from the object G and okay sorry and H, the point G and H. Okay, fantastic. I think the value of E will not change because it is once again C by A. Therefore once again 5 by 3 which is greater than 1. The others will not change, like the lattice rectum is once again 2B square by A. Now you see, you change it, everything will change accordingly. For now, this is a highly interesting way that the child will come and he will understand what is the difference between type 1 and type 2. First make type 1, save the file, and then make type 2 by simply changing the values. You have to just remember like this. Here there is no connection between A and B because A may be greater or B may be greater. But the only thing is the coefficient of x square is negative. There the coefficient of y square is negative. Now the child can understand better. But this is a very highly interesting one. Thank you. Let us learn to read.